Electric shock drowning, or ESD, is a little known and often unidentified killer.
Every year, ESD causes multiple entirely preventable deaths and injuries at marinas nationwide, including dozens of incidents that go undetected and unreported.
Everyone who boats on an inland body of water needs to understand the physical indicators of ESD, how to stop it, and what to do if you need to help an ESD victim.
Electric shock drowning occurs when alternating current, or AC, electricity flowing through the water passes through the body of an individual immersed in it.
Even very minute levels of leaked AC current create unpleasant tingling sensations and disturbing shocks, while low levels cause pain and loss of muscular control.
This current causes muscular paralysis, impairing one's ability to swim or stay afloat, which leads to drowning.
Electrical current can leak into the water as a result of faulty wiring and equipment on boats or docks. The absence of a safety ground, failure to separate green and white wires, or reverse polarity can cause ESD.
Extreme pain, severe contractions, and respiratory arrest occur at moderate levels, with severe burns, internal organ damage, ventricular fibrillation, cardiac arrest, and electrocution at higher levels.
And because of the relative connectivity of the human body versus fresh water, current levels lower than a third of that used by a 40-watt light bulb can be fatal.
The best defense against ESD is prevention.
Never enter the water within 150 feet of any dock or boat where AC power is in use.
If a person in the water exhibits ESD symptoms, immediately turn offshore power before conducting a rescue. Every year, Good Samaritans themselves become victims while attempting to save others experiencing harm from in-the-water electric shock. If you're in the water and experience tingling, move away from the dock or boat that is the likely source of leaking electricity.
To test if dangerous electrical currents are in the water around your boat, use an AC clamp-type ammeter with a minimum resolution of 100 milliamps.
With the boat connected to shore power and all onboard AC appliances turned off, clamp the cord with the ammeter. The reading should be zero.
Turn on heavy load cycling appliances like air conditioning, space heaters, and refrigerators, and retest to confirm a reading of zero.
Anything above 100 milliamps of current in freshwater and 500 milliamps in saltwater is dangerous and should be investigated immediately.
Owners and operators can improve safety around their docks by installing ground protection. Ground fault circuit interrupters easily can be installed at dock pedestals. These devices will trip if dangerous current escapes the dock.
Older boats can add whole vessel ground fault protection by installing equipment leakage current interrupters, which are now typically installed on new boats at their power panels.
Electrical systems with ground fault protection should be tested at least annually.
ESD is far more likely to occur in freshwater than saltwater. In freshwater, the body is a better conductor of electricity than the water itself.
Knowing where the dangers are and how to check for leaking AC electricity in the water could be a lifesaver.
Note that 12-volt direct current, or DC electricity, will not cause ESD, nor will 120-volt current from a boat's generator, unless another boat with an electrical fault is sharing the generator's electricity by means of a power cord.
In saltwater, electricity does not cause ESD because saltwater is more conductive than the human body.
The best advice for freshwater boating safety and ESD prevention is, when in doubt, stay out. Never go into the water near marinas, docks, or boatyards.